Hi, this is Mato. In this video, I will show you a game between Jerzy Seirawan and Pablo Zernitsky. This amazing chess game was played in Buenos Aires, Argentina, in 1993. Jerzy Seirawan had white pieces and he started with d4. Pablo Zernitsky played knight to f6, c4, e6, knight to f3, b6. The queen's Indian defense. Knight to c3. Bishop to b4, queen to b3, c5, asking a question, black to move, bishop to a5, keeping the pin, bishop to g5, knight to c6, white to move, e3, looks like a sensible move, perhaps it was expected. Instead, Jerzy Seirawan castled queen's side. Bishop takes on c3, white to move, queen takes bishop. Looks like a logical move, doesn't it? Jerzy Seirawan played d5. Bishop to e5. Pablo Zernitsky decided to keep his bishop. D takes on c6, queen to c7, and now g3. If knight takes on e5, queen takes on e5. g3 intending bishop to g2. Bishop to d6. Bishop to g2. D takes on c6. Who is better? Black is better. Materially, one pawn. But white is ahead in the development. How can white make the most of his better development? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Jerzy Seirawan sacrificed the exchange. Kaboom. What a move. Queen takes on d6. Rook to d1. Black is now even more better materially, but even more behind in the development. Black has only two active pieces, and all white pieces are active. Queen to c7. Bishop to f4. Queen to b7. Knight to e5. Bishop to d7. Given time, black would castle kingside, perhaps, and play rook to d8. With a fine game. But Jerzy Seirawan got another surprise. Anyway, what would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Please pause and find the best move for white. What did you find? Jerzy Seirawan sacrificed the second rook. Unbelievable chess. Knight takes on d7. Bishop takes on c6. White has two bishops against two black rooks. But the problem for black is, black rooks didn't have time to get in the game, while white bishops are ruling the board. Queen to a6, white to move. Perhaps some people would take the rook, what do you think? Jerzy Seirawan played knight takes on d7, preventing castling, threatening some kind of discover check. Queen to c8, attacking the bishop, bishop to a4, king to e7. If something like, let's play a random move, the knight takes on b6 check, winning the queen. So we have king to e7, queen to d3, black to move, f6. If something like rook to d8, then queen to d6 check, and after king to e8, knight to f6, double check, checkmate. Back to our game. f6, making room for the king. Queen to d6 check, king to f7. White to move. What now? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Jerzy Seirawan played another brilliant move. Knight to e5 check. What is this doing? This is a clearance sacrifice. White is vacating d7 square for the bishop. F takes on e5. Bishop to d7. Attacking the queen. Queen to d8. Queen takes pawn on e6 check, king to f8, bishop takes on e5, g6 offering the rook for free. But Jerzy Seirawan said, nah, I want your king. White played a move and black resigned, and the move is bishop to f6. Pablo Zernitsky resigned. If queen takes bishop, then queen to f6 check, king to g8, bishop to e6 checkmate. And let's go back. If queen moves to a safe spot, then queen to e7 check, and after king to g8, queen to g7, checkmate, the kiss of death. What a funny picture. The game ended. And black rooks are fast asleep. Compare them to white bishops, which were extremely active. What a game, what a game. What do you think of this game? Thank you for watching, and bye for now.